since we started talking about mathematical operation, again, I mentioned a couple of times that integers takes wholesome number, right? So a good example of that is like, I have 10 books and I wanna distribute it among students, right? So if I had 10 books and I had 9 students, I'm gonna have an extra book, right? So I'm just gonna give 9 and I'm gonna have extra 1. So I'm giving 1 for everybody. There's no way I can, you know, in this case, I can't really cut the book in half or like in 9, you know, pieces and provide an extra piece to everybody, right? So integer in a way works the same way. If you have a division, I'm not gonna take your partial number, right? So I'm dividing 5 by 2. I have 5 books and I'm spreading them by 2 people. I'm not gonna give 2.5 books for every person. I'm just gonna give 2, right? So I'm always gonna go with the lower and I just ignore the remainder. And that's just how kind of like this work. So if you wanted to kind of work with the division and like have actual number with a fraction with it, we have to do different type and we'll touch base on that as well. But now we're keeping it simple. If you needed to some math operation and you wanted to change things and you wanted to update that in an integer type, so just know that your integer will ignore the remaining of the division, right? So we're doing here a couple of examples. So if 1 by 2, we're saying a half and we're just ignoring the half as well and keeping it at 0, right? Again, I have 10 two pencils, right? And or like 2 students and I have 1 pencil. I can't really break it in half and give it to 2 people. I'm just not gonna give them anything, right? So that results in 0. there's also another operator that's probably not very familiar to some of you, which is called the module operator. It's that percent sign. So what does that percent sign really means? So it basically kind of helps you deciding how much left. So when I divide it 5 by 2, all I got is number 2. And that's basically what got stored, right? But what if I had a situation where I want to actually know how much left and I want to just exactly see that left? And that's when the mod operator here comes handy and can help you kind of determine the leftover, the remaining of the, you know, your basically division. So again, when we took the example, the 5/2, right? And if we ran the code here, we'll get the number 2. But I have about a half remainder, right? So if you divide 5 by 2, technically is 2, but you have 1 remaining, right? Like, so 2 by 2 is 4 and you have 1 remaining. So how do I tell that leftover is using that operation? So in this case, I said 5 modular 2. I'm basically saying, hey, if I took those 5 books and I had 2 students and I wanted to divide those 5 books between those 2 students, how much extra books I'm gonna be left with? So the code gonna go, okay, 5 by 2, it's gonna keep, I can divide them and I'm gonna have 1 book left that I can't really give to anybody. So that's your leftover, in this case, 1. If it was like a division that has no leftover, no reminder, for example, I'm dividing 20 books with 4 people. So this is gonna be a wholesome division, right? So I'm gonna say 20/4, that give me 4, I have no leftover. So I'm gonna give you 0, right? So that's kind of the idea. Like if you're trying to determine like my division, how it works and how much leftover, and you don't want to get into a situation where you are left with you know, extra value that you don't want to deal with, you can use that to give you an indication. Another really helpful way to use that is actually use it for deciding if it's a number is even or odd. So any number that is divided by 2 is what? It's an even number. It's not dividable by 2, it's an odd number. So in here, we're kind of making an if statement. We're checking, saying that if A, no matter what A is, because it's a variable, it's a black box to me, I don't know what it is, but whatever the value of A, if it's dividable by 2 and the leftover is 0, that means the number is even. And in any case that number, you divide it by two and you had a leftover, which is probably one or zero, you know, like that's the leftover you typically when you divide by two, it's going to be an odd number. So it's also a trick to use to kind of decide that. Okay. And again, we're just trying to get comfortable and kind of show you how cool things we can do here in the code. But definitely we'll practice those more as we go.